Hello, hello, and thank you for coming to today's session. I'm Jennifer Bagley, and I'm the CEO of CI Web Group, and today our entire session is about security, internet security and so forth. And today we're joined by our Director of IT and Senior Programmer, Chris Haney. I'm very excited. Normally he doesn't get to come out of the dungeon or the cave, some people call it, so I'm excited to be able to have him. If you would, say hello today.
Hello today.
And speaking of programmers, they're quite literal. So, many of you have heard me talk on multiple occasions regarding the type of talent you need to have, basically, that has your back as it relates to building your website, maintaining your website, managing your website, hosting it, as well as a big piece that I do not want to miss out on, which is security. Right now, what you're looking at is IRC, which is Internet Relay Channel, and Chris has us staring at, what is this? What channel are we on?
This specific channel is debit card. It's on Undernet, one of the many underground IRC networks out there.
Okay, so not that I want to hang out in Undernet or anywhere under anything on the Internet. However, what are we looking at? What is this?
What we're looking at is a bunch of people spamming or advertising their skills. This is basically like monster.com for people doing underground stuff, selling hacked computers, full credit card information, full security information, including social security. It's basically identity exchange.
Find me one. Can you, what are we looking for?
Well,
find me one where someone's selling credit card information.
Right here, there's actually quite a few different...
Pause it or highlight it, or is it just too fast?
We can actually go up and pause some of this and go up in the queue. Let's see here.
So if you can imagine, right now, we're looking at the Internet where credit card information is being displayed and sold. I'm starting with what I want to scare the absolute pants off of you, because I want to start with why you need to care about the security as it relates to your website as well as PC, server, and so forth. So this is why we're going to start here. All right, what do we have?
Refresh scums are people that just recently got their identity stolen. These are also called 0 day or 0 second stolen same day because there are one identity stolen every 5 seconds. So, you know, these 0 day dumps, so, you know, 101 series are chunks, if you will, Excel spreadsheets of people's full information, and they're sold like this. There are quite a few people in this. There's the hackers, the people who validate the credit card numbers, the wholesalers, the buyers, and the washers, and every single one of those people are here spamming with what they do and their availability to do it.
Okay, so I'm going to ask the hard question everybody's asking right now. How the heck is this legal?
It's not. It's just impossible to keep up with. Nobody has the ability to. No organized infrastructure has the ability to keep up with all of this. It happens every 5 seconds.
So, all of these people have huge databases with people's credit cards, social security numbers, birth dates, and they can literally go on here on the internet to a place. Could I get to here?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I've opened it up on your computer without installing anything in less than 30 seconds.
Okay. And they can sell them on here, too.
Correct. They sell the information. Sometimes they sell parcels. And parcels, what will happen when a parcel happens is it's missing either a social security number, it's missing the full account number, but they have basically the rest of the info, in which case it gets sent off to somebody that does some sort of social engineering where they call you to get the rest of the information and try to basically fill in the missing cell block.
That happened to my mom.
Really?
That happened to my mom, actually. This is relatively recently. Theirs was amazing because when they called, they actually said they were calling because she missed jury duty. And I had never, and my mom's married to my father, and we're all security geniuses, I would say, or at least above average.
Yeah.
And they called and said, "You missed jury duty, ma'am. Do you know how important it is to be at jury duty? You could get in a lot of trouble." And my mom's freaking out. She's like, "No, I didn't miss jury duty, and I wouldn't have done that." So then they started verifying information. So they had bits and pieces of her information and asked her to fill in the blanks.
Oh, my gosh.
Is that what you mean by partial?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, they'll find anything. Scaring is actually one of the most foolproof tactics out there. And not only do they do it verbally, but they'll do it through your computer too, because when I say, you know, partial info, part of that information is your computer and how to hack into it. So they'll install software to be able to get that information as well.
Okay. All right. Now, this is the thing. Actually, you know what? On the bottom of my website, I did a television show, and a lot of people have watched it. And I referenced this website called Millworm, which you showed me forever and ever and ever ago, which actually, when I saw it, it was hackers, and correct me if I'm wrong, but it was hackers actually going out to this website, Millworm, and they were posting their most recent hacks, whether you were using PHP or MySQL or WordPress or Joomla or any type of content management system. So as I understand, Millworm's gone now. It did get taken down by the government. So is that a fluke? Why aren't all these ones?
It takes a lot of information to be able to take one down. And one of the reasons why Millworm was actually taken down is because they were serving up real-time hacks. So exploit frameworks or people that were hacking computers were directly referencing Millworm to do it. So Millworm was the one doing the hacking. Information and, you know, the First Amendment and everything, that's still there. You can publish stuff. ExploitDB.com is an American, you know, company out there called Offensive Security. They spin themselves out to be a security company. However, they release full-blown sensitive information on how to break into computers utilizing things that are installed in the system, such as like Flash Player. You have Flash Player installed, specifically this version.
So what do you mean? This is going out to my computer. I'm not that smart, but this is going out to my computer, and it's saying, well, on her computer, she has Flash Player 10.1.5.3.6, whatever.
Yes.
And it's saying, because I have that installed on my computer, that is their door? Is that an open door?
Absolutely. And actually, the thing about that is right now, these exploits are becoming frameworks, which Microsoft created the .NET framework, which was the groundling for, you know, framework-based security holes as well. One of the biggest pieces of exploit framework is Fragus. Fragus will actually detect everything, just like Google Analytics does. It can see that you're using Firefox, you're using this version of Windows, everything. It uses JavaScript to be able to identify everything. Then it will go to this huge database, you know, this exploit database of code, and it will actually take that code and serve you the cookie that makes you get sick. It will actually...
Because it knows your symptoms.
Yeah, exactly. It knows everything about you, and it takes all that and then finds what will hurt you the most, and it will install it, which is the grounds laid for obtaining this kind of information.
Right. So we're working backwards, right? So the first place we started with is your credit card information, your personal identity is at stake, your clients, your website visitors, everybody's information is at stake, right? When I really get into these conversations, I freak out. And actually, for those of you who don't know, Chris and I are family, so otherwise he would scare me. But actually, I can call my mom, and I can tell my mom to call his mom, and I could get him in trouble. So all of this scares me to death, knowing that all this can be there. So I have a lot of people that say, well, you know, I'm just not going to participate on the Internet. Or you know what the best one is? When I'm talking to website owners, and they'll say, well, I have a good checker, valid CCs, check balances. Oh, Lord.
And just on another tool. See, not only do you sell software for automating this process, but RDP is Remote Desktop Program. So they actually sell 3,000 computers or software.
Cover over it.
I'm using my fingers and nobody can see.
Like here?
Yeah.
Okay.
So... This, for example, is they actually sell software that will scan the entire Internet for anybody that might have remote desktop enabled. And based off of that, it will be able to exploit that depending on versions and other things. But not only do they sell the software, but they'll sell a list of 3,000 computers that have been hacked, and it's any levels of selling. If I'm gonna buy a set of hacked computers, I'm going to pay $5,000 for around 30,000 of them.
Okay, but your definition of computer and the normal people's definition of computer is different, because I think of computer as my home PC.
When I say computer, I mean one that's one that has a hole or a server. Yeah, absolutely. These server computers are super important because they're what distributes these exploits or serves these exploits up to the people visiting.
Okay. So now let me back up. I have people that come in all the time, and we will talk about security as it relates to their website. I actually met with him. I'm not going to go too far into detail because some people know who he is. But I met with a security guy in the Dallas area. He's a more like protect security as in people.
Uh-huh.
And we pulled up his website. And do you remember? It completely, the pop-up came up. We're not going to go there. I knew you were about to go to his website. We can't do that. Through the band. Okay. But we actually, as soon as I went to his, I have a lot of security on my PCs, and it popped up, and I immediately knew something was wrong. So I went and grabbed Chris, and I was like, can we look at this website? Well, his website had been hacked, and his website actually was sending a executable file directly to my computer that had a man-in-the-middle attack. Or no, it wasn't a man. It was a keylogger.
Yes.
A keylogger, which when I brought it up to him, he said, well, I don't sell anything on my website, so my website doesn't need to be secure.
Mm-hmm.
But I was like, I just visited your website, and your website downloaded a keylogger onto my personal computer, and a keylogger tracks every keystroke. So when I went off of your website and I go to my bank, Chase bank account, and I log in, that data, it's not that he has that data, but that data went where? His computer is, his website is the virus, right?
Yes and no. It could be and it could not be, and I know that's kind of shady.
Right.
Usually what happens is when a website like that gets hacked, there's an iframe code placed on the website, told to go up to another website. Now, that means by going to your website, I'm being infected through this little, you know, hole into another website.
Pull up our site. Pull up CI Web Group.
Okay.
And then show me, let's look at what iframe is like that.
Okay.
So I went to his site. I thought I was on his site, but on his site, something was laid on top of it, like a blanket.
Yeah, or under it, which is more common because it's not visible to the human eye. Right now, what I'm going to do, for example, is replace this image with an iframe to Google. Now, Google, in this example, is going to be bad guy site. Actually, I'll even use bad guy site. I'm going to use exploit database and go back into here. And HTML.
So you're editing the front? You're editing the presentation layer of the site?
Correct. And inside of the presentation layer, it gives instructions for where to go to get information, including that stuff.
But I didn't see anything bad on his site when I went there visually.
Right. So now we have a hole going to exploitdatabase.com. Well, if I'm a hacker, I'm not going to make a big hole like that. I'm going to say width equals 1, height equals 1.
One pixel.
And then all of a sudden, I don't see it anymore. However, my computer is still instructed to go to that site and download all of its content.
So when I go to this website, when I went to his website, he could have had an iframe like that that's 1 pixel by 1 pixel tall.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't his website, but somebody, I don't understand that, though. How can somebody put that on his site? He had a free WordPress site. Somebody, it was just a downloaded WordPress, and then somebody installed a free theme.
Yeah, oh my gosh. There are 101 different ways. This is the easy type of hack to be able to add iframe source, and that can be done through cross-site scripting, or that can be done through a million and one different exploits. And this is exploits specifically to WordPress. They come out pretty much weekly, if not more frequently. Even open source plugins that have been looked at by the automatic team, you know, WordPress.org's commercial side.
Yes, continue.
And these things have actually been looked at, but local file inclusion. you know, that means that I can see your passwords file on your server. Now, this is a more scary vulnerability. This is the vulnerability that actually happens to where the hacker puts the nasty database code, then points 300 other websites that he hacks at your server. So you are the distribution method for this, for whatever viruses that he puts out there. If he puts out the Fragus exploit kit on your server, then you're literally not only distributing it to your clients, but you're distributing it to anybody who also has a vulnerable server. And there's actually legal actions that take place to people that are, because you're responsible for that.
So wait a minute. So Joe Blow is being cheap, and they say, I'm going to go download a WordPress because I can get a free WordPress, and I can download a free theme that was built by Shobako Shimraka from such and such, right?
Absolutely, very typical.
Okay. And I can get, so if I'm Joe Blow and I go do that, I can get in trouble if my website is serving up this virus?
Yeah, especially if there's updates and they can prove negligence. Proving negligence is so easy. All you have to do is be out of date on any kind of update.
So let's back up.
Uh-huh.
So first thing is, let's talk about WordPress. Open source, right? What other kind of content management systems are open source? Joomla?
Drupal. Concrete 5, iOS, millions of them.
Okay, so let me, in case you haven't heard me describe open source versus licensee, .NET Framework, or AST, is a Microsoft-based product. My programmers call it bloatware, I believe. Okay. I shouldn't have said that. However, has a lot of good uses, not great for building marketing websites, has a lot of other good uses, but we try and shy away from that for marketing websites. We're looking for something that's a little bit lighter. Now, open source. I don't know a better way to say it. So, okay, open source. Open source programmers, there's a series of different languages that are open source. MySQL is the database, that's the largest database that's open source, right?
Yes, second Postgres or Postgres, depending on where you're from.
Okay. And from a programming language, PHP, is that the largest open source language?
Definitely. Crawled to the top since PHP 5.0.
Okay. So WordPress is open source, which is actually, people think WordPress is a language or that it's a website. It's not. It's a framework, right?
Right.
It's a methodology.
Right.
And the methodology uses, let me see how smart I am, hooks, actions, and filters.
Yes, WordPress uses hooks, actions, and filters.
Okay.
Very good.
So this is WordPress, like many, the larger, this is what I want to get across, the larger the framework, whether it's MySQL, PHP, WordPress, the benefits are that you have a huge, huge, huge community of people who are developing, programmers, a mass amount of intelligence, resources, scalability, the library of resources is much, 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 much bigger, right?
Right. The code base and the amount of eyes looking at it is just huge.
Which, on the pro side, somebody that's looking to have a website built, if you use WordPress framework, you're using one of the most powerful platforms that there is in the world, right?
Yeah, it's like hiring a development team for, a few thousand people.
Exactly.
That have been developing it for the last 8 years.
So you're getting millions and millions of dollars of development work, right?
Yes.
Okay. The con is, the larger the framework,
the more code.
The more code, the more open doors.
And it's completely visible. And that's the thing about, whenever I download a plugin, that's how these guys find all this entire list, was because somebody opened up GigPress plugin, and somebody looked for every single piece of stored JavaScript variable, like chunks of memory allocated to letters, and actually looked at it and reverse engineered it. That's a perfect word. Reverse engineering is completely possible with open source because you can look at it and go backwards.
Okay, so but this is the thing. Because it's the biggest platform in the world, that means it has the most amount of hacks, threats, security needs, right?
Yeah, it's a big target.
It's a big target, right? So now here, if I have a website that has a million unique visitors on a monthly basis, or I have a website that has 10 unique visitors on a monthly basis, which one's better for the hackers?
Well, of course, the bigger one.
The million, right?
Yeah, it's worth more traffic.
So this is the thing. When I'm talking to small and mid-sized business owners, and they're talking about choosing these content management systems, it scares me to death because when they put together their request for proposals and whatnot, I don't see them addressing security at all. In fact, I see them addressing hosting, and they want $10 hosting. They don't care about maintenance. You said 15 times since we've been talking that you have to have upgrades, you have to have people who are monitoring all of these channels where all of these viruses and these hacks are posted, right?
Oh, yeah. There's network security is a big piece of the security that's always been collected, especially in the hosting realm.
So if I go download my free WordPress, woohoo, and I get my free theme from Czechoslovakia, right, woohoo, and my free theme has what in it?
Exploit framework. there's things as harmless as ad systems that will inject ads on every 10th time the page loads, you know, friendly stuff like that, to haha joke, you know, I'm fighting for a cause, you know, this is my A-Rap, whatever brother built, and he's doing a, you know, whatever dance. And, I mean, they can do funny stuff, or they can do absolutely malicious stuff, or they could be taking your visitors' data, sending all the statistical data, and that's the most common that I see, sending your browser's, your user statistical data, instead of to Google Analytics, to Hacker ABC Marketing Group, because it's all, I mean, realistically, it's all about money.
So, but if I'm a hacker, is one of the best ways I can get access to people's websites by giving away beautiful free themes?
Oh, yes. Oh, absolutely.
So it kills me every time I'm talking to someone and they're like, oh, it's just a WordPress.
Nothing.
And then they're saying, all the themes are free. Right. What do you mean? You know what it reminds me of? The Facebook, I'm going to send you a Mother's Day card.
Yeah.
And they create the third-party app, and they do it 3 days before Mother's Day because we all want to send Mom's Day cards because we love our moms.
Yeah.
But the whole thing is designed to...
Yeah.
Steal all your contact data and spam the crap out of them or something.
Yeah, absolutely. A, they did it purely for charity, and they're really, really some big-hearted folks, and they just really want to, you know, spread the love. B, they're getting, you know, some sort of financial profit out of it in one way or another. They're stealing your customer's data and selling it, or they're hacking them, you know, where the spectrum goes on. But they're doing it for a reason. They're not just giving away free stuff because they're really, really – nice people. Even WordPress has the commercial site automatic. At least they're not shady about it. That will, you know, they have a commercial site for them where they sell legitimate products.
They sell. So does anybody regulate all those free themes? Go to Google and go type in free WordPress themes. I feel bad, but you know, most people were rookies. But you know, the worst part is too, is we have kids, our teens and our 20s, and I call them the triple S, like friends, family, and fools,
yeah,
who are normally who people hire to build their website.
it's always nice to, you know, hook your nephew up with a job or your husband.
Yeah, because your nephew can go to Google and they can type in free WordPress themes. So should I be worried about any of these?
Oh, yeah. Especially, okay, here's actually a really big deal I want to point out.
Okay.
So WordPress has a thing about their – let's find it. Okay. This is it. For various reasons related to our trademark, we ask that you do not use the word WordPress in the domain. Okay. So you can guess that WordPressThemeBase.com has absolutely no affiliation with WordPress.org. So they have –
Because WordPress is only WordPress.org, WordPress.net, and WordPress.com.
Right, right. So if you have Word, I mean, these guys are basically have a trademark infringement already. So everything that they're giving away for free, I can almost guarantee has some sort of code in it that is going to do something that might not be desired by the website owner.
Can you pull up? We have tons and tons of people that come to our office, and they say, oh, I have a WordPress site. And I'm like, okay, well, let's go look at your code, right? So we go in and we go look at a footer. Can you show them quickly what encoded footers look like?
Yeah. Let me figure
it out. Probably need to switch screens and stuff.
Just
so
download this bad boy. I guarantee it has encoded malarkey in it.
Malarkey is a good word.
Always malarkey.
We're saying malarkey when we're being recorded. You know, I feel bad because the cheap way out is not the good way out. It just never is. And, you know, on one hand, I could go into, but you're going, you downloaded the theme, right?
Perfect. The first one I picked.
Free theme.
Jibber, 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 jibber.
So what is that?
Well, let's find out. Actually, it's a Base64 encoding, which isn't incredibly difficult to hack.
The hacker is trying to put something in the footer.
Whatever it is. We don't know.
We have no clue.
Yeah.
And you can't read it. And you installed this on your, the website owner installed this on their, downloaded it to their computer, uploaded it to their free WordPress, and then now it's on their server, right?
Yeah. So whatever this is being actually executed on their server. And it was through an email, which is even worse.
So where are you at? What is this?
I just Googled for Base64 decoder. Base64 is a really easy
You're really freaking smart.
Way to decode some of this stuff. And see, this one specifically.
What is that link?
This one is advertising Nokia. So the person who made this thing, and this one might be a little bit more.
On the up and up.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they're just advertising on your site. So all of this jarble equals this. So it has all rights reserved, whatever the blog name is or website name is, this front page, counts the number of posts. And unfortunately, there's no way to change it, even if you want to change it. So you're kind of pinned into that, too.
You know how to change that.
Well, I do. I mean, there's... you got lucky with one of the good cousins.
So what is that whole just what you think it... Okay, well, that's good. So that's what an encrypted footer looks like, which 99% of people who own free WordPresses downloaded a free theme have that there, but they don't know what it does. So what are some of the things that you've seen them do? We've looked at tons of cases.
And we actually made one that would – some of these are actually encoded and encoded and encoded in like 300 different ways, and usually if it's like that, you'll see some nastiness. You'll see what's called you'll see a PHP function for fsoc, which is for .NET/curl, and that's what curl does is it actually is a PHP function that will send data from one server to another, such as that. So they'll actually you'll decode it and you'll see this kind of junk, and you'll see that it's actually sending your server sensitive information to their server.
So is this the same situation we were talking about earlier where I went to his site, I knew immediately I had something downloaded on my computer. Could it have been the footer that did it?
Oh, yes. And, I mean, the other thing that they do is, like, the one that we saw that was really nasty, it actually bubbled out to all the other themes and then attached it to the functions.php file at the bottom of it. Right here. And so every time the web page was loaded, it would reinfect itself. So you could be like, oh my gosh, I made a mistake. Click on install, and you ain't getting rid of it. It's going to be stuck because every time you load a page, before you could change anything, it reattaches
itself.
Yeah. So, I mean, there are ways to do it. You know, all you have to do is break into, you know, a shell like this and go through and delete it out of this area. But that's something separate.
Okay. Okay, so let's say that we have a really, really smart cookie on our hands.
Yeah.
And they hired somebody that was actually a developer, not a theme designer, to actually install WordPress, build or design their own custom design, and the site goes up. It's clean, they did a security check, fantastic, and then they threw it up on GoDaddy to host it, and they handed it over to the website owner. The website owner starts playing with these things called plugins.
that's the plus, and I mean, it's like giving a, I hate saying this, but
like giving
a kid
a gun. That's all I could think about.
Yeah, when you're describing it, I mean, because that's what it is, and unfortunately, people, like, aren't going to go in and download the thing locally and like I did and open up footer.php and know exactly what to look for and exactly where to look for it. They're just going to pray it works. And And that's about the size of it.
So we have, there's, how many plugins are there out there?
Millions.
Millions of plugins. Could you download a plugin that was clean and didn't have any security threats, but then later got upgraded and became?
Yeah. So a lot of people get pissed off because, excuse me, can I say that?
You can say that. A lot of people get mad because
they release these open source applications expecting donations and don't get donations. And their next update, because it's already been approved by Automattic, will have that in. That's actually so frequent.
So when they, if they get it approved by Automattic, it can be a clean plugin.
Right.
And then later on when they do their upgrades, no one rechecks it?
Right. They're found all the time in there. It's called a subversion repository. It's like where it's like a development playground. And like I've gone through the development playground of things that are being developed and seeing people develop them.
Okay. All right. So I hope I'm scaring the pants off you, because that's the goal, and you should be scared. Because I see this all the time, and it makes me so frustrated. By the way, the security guy meeting that we had left and said it wasn't his job to need to do anything with his website, and he updated nothing. So anyway, we'll leave that alone. Chris, you always talk about – actually, let's do a quick summary, the difference between PC security and Internet security, as in your website, and then we have server security, and then we have, like, things like Facebook.
Okay, wow. So starting out with, starting out with PC security, I mean, the best thing that any user can do to protect themselves is obviously have the best kind of antivirus that you can have installed, and believe it or not,
it's McAfee and Norton, right?
No. Sorry.
Bloatware?
Yeah. And a lot of people call, and I know I'm going to make somebody mad here, but, like, a lot of people call Norton the virus because it is almost impossible to get off
your computer. I've never been able to get it off if it comes on.
Yeah, so it's just like, and then McAfee is so commercialized that if you do download any kind of free thing like Notepad++, that all of them want to install the Ask Toolbar, and all of them want to install a free trial version of McAfee. And shoot, when you buy your laptops from the store, they come with all this pre-installed garbage because computer manufacturers get paid a ton to be able to put those in there. They get these huge contracts. So your computer basically comes to you in a big piece of garbage, unfortunately.
Okay, so average Joe, buy a new computer, what do we download?
Avast
antivirus?
Right now.
AVAST?
Yeah, right now, hands down, it is free to the user. Don't install any toolbars if it ever asks you. Right now it doesn't, but it might in the future. But their whole goal is to get the average user using it, making it free under the I forget what kind of license it's called, but basically it makes it free for the home user, free for students, and for any kind of corporate entity, they have to purchase it. Their methodology is become known, you know, like because it was a hard hard market to get into. I mean, Norton's and McAfee, Kaspersky, and all the other antivirus really had a hold on the market, so they need to get out there. What better way to make the best product free?
Okay, so Avast, that's PC. That's protecting your computer. Now, protecting your website from, one, getting infected, because it can get infected too, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And the more traffic you get, the more opportunity that it is to get infected. Is that a true statement? The more traffic your website has, the more that...
The bigger target you are.
The bigger target you are.
Right.
Okay. And the open source, are you a bigger target if you're open source? Kind of.
Yeah. Basically, because closed source, nobody can get into it. And the thing is, the script kiddies these days, people that... you know, don't even know how to code, can install a framework. It's like installing a program. So they find your exploit using an exploit database, AutoPwner, or whatever, PWNER, and then they launch their Fragus, and it's like point-click. It's like learning any kind of piece of software.
Okay, so let me go back to the computers. I hear people say all the time that if you own a Mac, you can't get a virus.
So true. Oh, my gosh. Actually, I just saw this one, and it hit the news because so many Macs were infected.
Let me tell you real fast how I look at it.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, no, there's just not enough Mac users yet for the hackers to go after them.
Oh, no. RAT is known as a remote access Trojan, and they started it because of that, because they're...
That is for a Mac.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. And it is full remote control software for the Mac, and it's based off of trending. Same thing with smartphones. Not enough people using them, not the case. They see the trends going up. Hackers are going to be there before commercial people are there. Yeah. So,
so if you own a Mac, whoever told you, what is it?
It's a video of how they take control of your webcams to be able to watch you on Macs.
Watch you?
Yeah, they can actually watch you with your cameras.
So I own a Mac, and you're telling me Alibaba can be watching me?
Oh, yeah. From
my video?
Yeah, give him a little wink. I mean, we don't have that one going, do we?
No.
Wink and say hi to Alibaba.
No.
Absolutely.
And I don't mean anything by that. I'm just throwing out random. It's the only thing I know. To say Steve is watching me, actually. Steve is 14.
Oh.
Your son.
I know, right?
Yeah. Oh, that is so weird.
Yeah, this right here is a list of hacked computers and IP addresses that he's pulling up. But, yeah.
Yeah, so you're not safe. Okay, what was this? We went to this earlier and the big Trojan, wait, go to your Mac Paint because you took a picture of my Trojan. So we went to this image, and images are a huge way to get viruses too.
Yes,
kind of.
Canvas, yeah. Anything in HTML5 canvas images, the newer technology, and hackers are always on bleeding edge technology. So the image, I'm trying to think of the name of it. It's you can actually encrypt stuff inside of images, binary data inside of images, to be able to transmit data other than what your browser is rendering as an image. Now, this is what happens after you go to Joe WordPress's site who didn't keep his site up to date. Your computer, as you remember this area, this is a black version of the same screen. Each one of these users are actual people, and the list of their names is up here. Now, each one of these and this one are automated bots. Now, by bots, I mean your computer went to this website. It automated downloading the worst Trojan ever. It automated joining this channel, and now Hacker Bob can control, or Maxwell in this case, that it says down below. Where is a little colorful way to highlight this? Like Maxwell down here can issue a command to all the bots saying, "Hey, please take down Amazon.com. I don't like them. They ripped me off on shipping."
Okay. So this is when Hacker Maxwell, for example, he slowly infects thousands of websites.
Exponentially, too.
Millions of websites. And or fast, or quickly, right? And
yeah.
Each one of those websites then becomes his army.
Right,
a battalion.
Yeah, and the word zombies used a lot. And zombie armies will go out, you hack two computers, those computers scan the internet looking for vulnerable websites, people who don't update their WordPresses or whatever else, and they will automatically detect the vulnerability, upload the thing. This is all part of large exploit frameworks, which is why 1 in 5 people 5 years ago were infected.
So what is it now?
It's a ridiculous number. It's like 1 in 2. I mean, half the computers out there are sitting in one of these chat channels. They have no idea their computer because they're always on the internet. It's like this could be this computer right here, this little guy. And this computer could be hacking other computers right now because it's being issued commands at a CC, command and control station, which is IRC. Now,
if that's my computer, I could get in trouble? If that's my website hacking those other sites?
Well, not really, because it happens all the time. Well, it's one of those things. Like, you can get in trouble for it, and it has happened, especially in the U.S. If the CC is in the U.S. and then so is your computer, then you have a very, very large chance of somebody knocking on your door and saying, hey, can we please seize all of your equipment? And usually they do, and, you know, the U.S. government, when they can coordinate themselves, can confiscate your computer, because that's what you're doing. You wait in the cell block while they're doing it.
Nice.
And then they'll go through and find out, okay, it really wasn't them, you know, performing this attack or doing, you know, hacking into the Pentagon's whatever. It was a bot controller that was installed by XYZ's website.
Oh, wow.
And then it gets tracked back to XYZ's website, in which it goes down for maintenance for a while. Well, they go to the data centers in Chicago or Dallas and take your server physically out of its rack and say, how did this get here? Did you put this here on purpose? You know, they're at that point responsible for not updating their stuff.
Okay, all right. Open up Chrome real quick. Go to Facebook.
Chrome.
So we've talked about websites. Your website is one of the biggest potential opportunities for people to attack, and also it can become the attacker in a nutshell, right? So to break down everything that we just said, and I know we didn't skim the surface because this is something you love. However, websites require maintenance. They require maintenance every single day, all day. They require also, click on profile, will you? They also require basically monitoring. Like you go out to, or not you necessarily, but our team, our security team, they go out to all these different hacker sites, and they're keeping an eye out for all of these different hacks that are coming out, right?
Yep. Sure.
And then you're
Black
creating
hat.
Patches?
Yeah. Some of the things that we do, like one of the exploits that we found was one of the little nastier ones, and we didn't experience any kind of, you know, any kind of detriment from this, but the rest of the world did because it became public, and only after it became public, several days later, the exploit was fixed because fixes come out after they come out. We, you know, have the ability to proactively go through and look through it as a hacker. Some people say the best defense is a good offense. I think that's...
Yeah, it's funny because when our sales team, I feel bad for them because every time they're in meetings, we always have the client that goes, well, you guys charge $99 for hosting. And, you know, I feel bad because the sales reps are like, no, actually, we charge nothing for hosting. Hosting's free. We charge $99 a month for maintenance and support and training and all these upgrades and security and monitoring all these hacker sites and having to upgrade websites not just for hackers but for all the different browsers and all the different mobile apps and everything else. So, yeah, it's, you know, it's...
Hosting doesn't cost anything.
Hosting's free. Well, I mean, it's... But 99% of the world, they have no clue. I mean, it's... They don't understand, like, the difference between a domain registrar... who's hosting your website? What does hosting mean? What does maintenance mean? Does GoDaddy maintenance your WordPress? Nope.
No, not at all.
If you call them, they'll charge you $75 for...
No, $175 for expert hand.
$175 for expert hand.
No.
And that would be if you were smart enough to know that WordPress came out with an upgrade. And that upgrade affects 30 different plugins. And can break other plugins and everything else. So you have to make sure everything's compatible too. So anyway, my Facebook is not loading.
Oh.
That's five. So tell me this. I have a rule in my house. I have a 12-year-old little boy, and he's not so little anymore actually. He is not allowed to use third-party apps on Facebook. There we go. So if there's whenever you go through my profile, you're going to notice on. You're not going to see. Thank you. Aw, that was funny. So you're not going to see Easter eggs, Mafia Wars, someone taking a quiz on somebody. What? You're excited.
My Facebook actually. Oh my gosh. And this is a never do thing. Okay, there's a reason why you have security settings on your Facebook. Today.
Should we start this over into a Facebook security session?
Oh my gosh, I copied.
Okay, wait.
No, like code
we're gonna do this.
Oh,
I saw that.
You saw that? Come
yeah,
out?
I did. Okay, all right. You guys, this is way too long. I know this is way too long, and we're so excited. I'm glad that you came. I hope you're just as enthusiastic about security as we are, especially as he is. We're gonna wrap this session up. Because I know this has been a long training. I hope this is important. I hope that when you are looking for your web partners, that you have a ton of questions that you can possibly ask them to see what the level of knowledge and expertise is as it relates to security, PC, web, internet, social media, and so forth, because it's absolutely critical that you have people on your team representing you that understand the dangers. And, of course, my man over here has a mass amount of security experience to continue with the government. And he was in Iraq and did a lot of security things there, too. So I won't go too into detail for that. But if you need help, please don't hesitate. If you've got a 911 or emergency, you need help right away, you want to talk to one of our guys, you want us to look at your site, please don't hesitate to contact us. You can go to ciwebgroup.com/fusion. You can fill out the contact me link that's right on the front of the site. Or if you're listening to one of our podcasts on iTunes right now, you can go ahead and text the word web, W-E-B, to 313131. Text the word web to 313131, and we will make sure and get one of our specialists in touch with you, get you set up for a consultation, and we'd be happy to help you. Other than that, we're going to come back on our next session. We're going to talk a little bit about security as it relates to the social media environment, and I probably could have broken down this into 5 or 6 classes, so we'll probably have a few more after this as well. Again, thanks for coming, and we'll talk to you soon.
Thank you. Please stand by.